I like to talk a little about one of my favorite Elvis Presley releases, the Milestone release from 1992, Elvis Presley, the King of Rock and Roll, the complete 50s masters. And I like to talk a little about its history and the impact it had on me, because I had been a fan for about 5-6 years already when this came out. And this was out of this world, so good. But a little backtrack then. Like I said, this came out in the summer of 1992. And it marked the 15th anniversary of Elvis Presley's passing in 1977. And it was commissioned by RCA and BMG Music. And this was their most ambitious project to date, because since the early 1990s they had started a series called Elvis in the 90s. I show it. This is a promotional disc here, but this was a series to present Elvis Presley's recorded catalog in proper context, where there's remastered the tapes and released CDs in till then the best quality, because so much of Elvis Presley's recorded legacy had been treated so badly throughout the years, and there was a lot of controversy about Elvis Presley's 50s recordings, because for many, many years they used the electronically reprocessed stereo tapes and not the original monaural original RCA tapes. But for this release they went back to the original tapes in most cases, and the sound is fabulous. And the producers included Ernst Mikael Jorgensen and Roger Semon, and they were well-known people for us Elvis fans, and they really excelled with this box. And like I said, they dug out the best copies of tapes and acetates and remastered the whole thing, and the sound is amazing. In original mono, when mono was the original mode, and it's better to listen to it in mono. And the set contains like 140 songs and 14 or 15 previously unreleased recordings, so it was like a Christmas gift to us fans in the summer of 1992. And there were different sizes. Here you see the American edition in the size of 7-inch times 12-inch, and the European vinyl version was released in 12 by 12 size, so like an album size. And if we take a look inside it, I prefer this vinyl edition. I mean, Elvis Presley on vinyl to me is, it's great. Contains a booklet which is bigger than the US edition, bigger in size, but only half of the pages, of course. I think the US booklet was about 100 pages, whereas this one is 50 pages, but it's fantastic. And photos from the Graceland archives, probably from the Colonel's collection, which they had obtained in the early 1990s. Great discography, a great sessionography, and just a fantastic box. There was a lot of work transferring the negatives from that American size to the US European size, so they had to like rework everything in the printing department, so it was took a lot of job. And the booklet contains a great essay by Peter Guralnick, He's a well-known writer and just a fantastic travelogue through the 1950s with Elvis. And there was also a big promotional campaign, I think the biggest to date. And I don't think they have done a promotional campaign since then, that size. And there were radio and TV commercials, and there were additional promotional releases, radio and CD singles, and just a fantastic time to be an Elvis Presley fan. And I just want to say that this box made a great impact on me, and you know, I was so stunned by it. And even BMG themselves, they were a little reluctant at first, because they never thought that a box selling at like $79 at retail would attract too many buyers. But so they just ordered like 20 or 30,000 copies. Well, a little later it had sold like 500,000 copies worldwide, so this was a sensational release. And like I said, I go for the LP version, because Elvis on vinyl to me is just fantastic. And I just want to say that Elvis, the king of rock and roll, the complete 50s masters, is a fantastic release. Either way you go, if you buy the American version or the vinyl version from Europe, you can't go wrong with a country song. So thank you very much for viewing this one, and hope to do something for you again soon. Bye.